Yo, everybody, welcome to the Machine Room Podcast, where Nas and Rachel start with a topic and end up in the deep web of conversation. Now sit back, relax, crank it up, and give it up for your host, Nasdradamics and Hammer of Venus.
To the Machine Room Podcast. There was no fuck ups in the beginning. It started off perfect. 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 If anybody else tells you otherwise, they're lying. There was no fuck up in the beginning at all.
That's a new guy.
It was perfection. Round of applause for us, but especially a big round of applause for Jared Martinez, a.k.a. Mind of Martinez 2 on Twitch. Follow him, please. He plays retro games, new games, mostly all retro. He's a retro gamer, but he's very funny as hell. A good friend of the Machine Room Podcast. I think voice. A great voice. His voice cracks me up. And he's a real good person. I met him, I think, twice. I think I met him twice. There was a time when it was him and a whole bunch of other people that came to C2E2 over here. We got to hang out. It reminds me though. No, I think it was just once because that was a time it was him. I think it was him, Ashy, some other people. I forgot who, man. I'm sorry if I remember. And I was with my ex at the time, and they were having some kind of like. Oh shit, you're like huge as hell. They were having some kind of party or whatever, like her friends. And then the guys were in town, so I was like, hey, why don't you come over? It was a stupid idea, actually. I shouldn't have invited them over. I was like, hey, why don't you come over? So then they came over, they were part of this. So there was all these freaking chicks, and they were all fancy and bougie and high class. And then it's me. And my boys from the hood, you know what I'm saying? Like urban geeks and shit. And it was awkward, especially to the point where it got to a pain for it. And then try to divide the check.
Yeah.
It was just weird. And I'm sure it was a bad idea. But you know what? I laugh at it now. Fuck that. You know, I'm glad it happened. Matter of fact, you know, I hope I made you look horrible and shit like that. It was funny. So that's my memory of that shit. But
that's hilarious.
It is hilarious. A lot of things are hilarious. Starting off this year, things have been popping off. We had Gypsy Rose out there doing her thing. You know, people are all like, yeah, be free. And now they're like, all right, we're a little bit sick and tired of you. You need to... Yeah. You need to stop.
Apparently, her husband, like, has the dick.
The D. Gypsy's getting it. Deep. Okay? And we should be happy for her. I mean, she's been in jail for 8 years. She should be getting the D.
She has a black eye. So we think, why do you have a black eye? It's like, shit got weird.
She's been in the pen. She likes it rough, you know? That's all I'm saying. She's been in the pen. She likes it rough. And we got...
She busted out for 10 years.
I want to know how they... Well, apparently, they probably pen pals or something, right? That's how they met or whatever.
Yeah.
I saw a comedian. He said, like, you seen Gypsy Rose's husband? He looks like the What's the dude from King of Queens? Kevin, what? Fuck. Here we go. Machine Room Podcast. We don't remember shit. Come on, guys, help me out here. The King of Queen Dude, Kevin something. I just got Kevin Hart in my head, but he's not Kevin Hart.
No, it's not, and I can't get Kevin Hart out of my head.
It's not Kevin Smith either. That's the guy from Clerks.
What Kevin, is his name?
Come on, Paul Blart. Kevin James.
James. Thank you. Scooby.
Cat Williams. William. No. Anyways, the comedian said that Gypsy Rose's husband looks like the Kevin James meme, you know, where he's just like,
oh,
like he was the defender, like he has that swag, you know. So that motherfucker, Kevin James, is giving Gypsy Rose the D right now. That's what it is. And then we had that to freaking possible alien invasion at a Miami mall that caused ruckus. Like had
what
all
happened?
This, like no
all
nobody.
I saw somebody like tweeted or something. They're like, oh, they're. Something about aliens at the mall, and then it was just a bunch of kids fighting.
But that's the thing. Like, it's either... See, I gotta fix the screen again. I'm sorry about that. It's either kids were fighting. They say it's kids fighting fireworks, but then they're saying it was an alien invasion, and there was portals opening, and big shadowy figures were coming out, and people were running. But there's what? No... Ah, son of a bitch. There's no fucking proof of anything. Like, how is something like this happening... And nobody has video of anything.
Dude, anything. That's the first thing people nowadays do. I'm just going to watch.
So the conspiracy that they have been all quieted, people's memory has been erased, and they've been deleting anything, you know, it's a conspiracy of all that shit because there really isn't anything there. And why would they call a fucking the whole Miami force to go to this mall for just kids, like, fucking around, you know? Maybe 20 squads, but...
The Pegasus. I've seen the Pegasus. It was right over there. The Pegasus.
Is it my fault that I just want aliens to be true? Like, oh, shit. They're coming, you know? And the thing is that it wasn't from when you hear the stories... It wasn't like they came out and started attacking people. It was just they came through a portal and they were just walking. People were like, ah! And just started running. They were getting shot at. These aliens did nothing. If it was aliens, they went to the mall to try to shop. And they got... And you know why? Because they were black aliens. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about... Hold on. Let's talk about races against black aliens. They just came to the mall trying to get the new Nikes or some shit, and y'all motherfuckers just ran and shot up. You know what's even bad? What's even worse is the fact that even the black people were running from the black aliens. If anybody should have been like, yo, what up, my brother? Oh, shit, there's some of us in space. But no, y'all motherfuckers like, oh, shit, get the fuck out of here. You see, that's fucking racism within your own kind from a different species. That's fucked up.
Word.
How do you mix up aliens and teens? Exactly.
Honestly, I wish I had been there. Not to, like, see the aliens. I just wish I could have seen everybody running around like dickheads and then starting fights.
I mean, look. Rule number one when you grew up in the hood, if you see people running, you run with them. You don't ask questions, okay? So, I get it. Everybody just fucking ran. Nobody stayed there. But there had to be someone in the fucking epicenter of whatever was happening that was like, oh, shit, and then turned and recorded as you're running. I'm just saying, we got, like, we have, like, every damn angle and footage of 9/11, but we don't got footage of a potential aliens going through portals in a mall in Miami.
What about, like, security cameras and shit? Like, there's got to be something.
Show us the footage. Like Cloverfield.
Cloverfield, yeah.
Even Cloverfield happened. And they had to, even though it was fake, but it was great. Cloverfield's a great movie.
It is great.
I haven't seen that in a minute. But Cloverfield's a great movie. So then we got those two events, and then you got the Flying Felon. I love the Flying Felon. It is fucking hilarious. Have you seen the footage?
I did. I saw it on TikTok. Did I didn't see the whole thing. I just saw him do that fucking, like, Scrooge McDuck dive.
Mm-hmm. And I just love it because he literally said, "Oh man, fuck this bitch," and then ran. That's what made it more hilarious. He said it loud as hell. You hear him clear as day. "Oh man, fuck this bitch," and just ran to her. Undertaker dive over the ropes.
That's hilarious.
Took a whole team
to die. Came to show the world.
And then when he, of course, he fucked himself over, and then he comes back and they got him like, yeah. Hannibal Lecter. You saw that?
I saw that. I was like, wow, they got him on lock.
And he's the epitome of, you know, you done fucked up. You know you done fucked up. Don't you I know have that?
What he can do for the rest of his fucking life in prison, or however long he's going to be in there, every day all he's getting is high fives. Yeah.
Yep. He's going to walk in the room, they're going to be like,
"Shaboy!
Oh!" Hey, yo, it's that motherfucker. Yo, you crazy as hell, dog.
Good love you, man.
Hey, this motherfucker right here, this is the dude right here. Mad respect in the hood. Mad respect in the pen.
Man.
Do let his immersive thoughts leak out. Phantom
a
Knight.
Bit, yeah.
Yep. Protect yourself from mayhem. Like me? Scooby say no, he's isolated from everyone else.
For now. They're going to give him his food through that little slot and they're going to high five.
He's going to say, "Man, fuck this shit," and go right through that little slot. Slide right in through there because he's a meta human. He's the first ever meta human, is that guy.
Yes. Perfect dive.
Ah, it's been great.
Should take that and then, like, do the diving score people with the little cards. 9.8. 10.
That should be in the Olympics. Think about it. That should be an Olympic, like we're gonna start the Hood Olympics, and that's gonna be a fucking one of the things. The Felon Olympics, yes, the Felon Olympics, like Broly Fizz just said, and one of them is that fucking the what do you call that? Where the judge sits.
The banister.
That's a big ass banister. That's a high fucking ass banister.
I don't know.
Motherfuckers got right now that guy has the record because he got some ups. I don't know if the bench, that's right. It is the bench. Bless you. It is the bench. You know, walk up to the bench. So this guy right now has the record on the bench dive because. Did he train? Did he train for that shit? Did he go like one day, man, swear, I'm going to jump over that shit and fuck a motherfucker up.
He's in the yard running and practicing. Like, hey, man, what the fuck you doing?
To his cousins? No. Put that shit higher. I know, dog. I've been at court like about 15 times. Put that shit higher. All right. Bet.
Cool.
The judge bench jump. Yep, that is. Gold medal to the judge bench jump goes to that one guy. You got the Timberland boot relay race.
That food stamp card throwing.
Bro, I was always amazed that people do a lot with some Tims on. I can't do nothing with boots. My friend Sony, when I met him, he was purely boots. This motherfucker was doing everything with boots. We'll be in the summer, shorts, tank top, boots. I'm like, dude, wear some gym shoes. He's like, oh, I don't wear gym shoes. And this motherfucker was doing everything with the boots. Then eventually he evolved into gym shoes. But man, that guy had his boot game right.
I did that with combat boots, like Vietnam era combat boots. And I fucking wore those everywhere. Even I even wore them without socks. I was just like, I love these fucking things.
You were stomping the yard.
Exactly.
Was it the combat boots that go like almost to your calves or up to the calves?
Yeah, they were so, the all black leather ones, like from the Crow.
Oh shit.
I'm like this little goth kid. And I'm like, yeah, I finally got some combat boots. I wore them to death.
You wore them till they were talking, until they started talking. Till your toes started showing.
Exactly.
Oh, Scoobies. Venus
wearing combat boots like some Air Force Ones.
They were literally.
If somebody bought me some Air Force Ones, I'd wear them.
Scooby used to wear Air Force Ones like crazy. They were the unofficial official shoes of the XPW when we used to do the basement wrestling. And it was him and like two other people. And I said, I love these shoes because when they kicked me in the face, it didn't hurt as much. They're real soft at the bottom, you know?
That wasn't so bad.
Yeah. So I was like, these are the unofficial official shoes of the Extreme Basement Wrestling. Did I ever have Air Force Ones? Nope.
Nope.
Do they even still sell Air Force Ones? Damn, that was hard as hell for me to say.
I've always wanted like the late 90s era Adidas.
My Adidas. Broly's Fist says they do. I had Adidas, but that was because they were my brothers. And what I remember is that they fucked up my feet.
Really?
Yeah, like, you know, they're not very comfortable with soles. So after wearing those Adidas, my feet, like, no, I need a cushion in my shoes after that, you know?
That's what it's like to wear Converse shoes. Like, they look cool and shit, but there's nothing on the inside. It there might as well isn't. Be, like, floor tile inside the shoe.
There isn't.
So I have the one with the star.
The Chucks?
No, not the Chucks.
I put something in there. You know?
Yeah, when I was working at Walmart, I put the big ass soles in there that they like measure your feet for.
Yeah.
And that, yeah. But like regular, like Chuck Taylor's, like, Fairly Fist says, Chucks feel like I'm wearing CD album covers.
Yup.
When I first moved to California, I had these all black Chucks and I loved them. Like, I'd lace them all the way up and shit. And when I was first working at Best Buy, we were throwing away a bunch of boxes and the whole shoe ripped off the sole and I had to go home and change shoes.
Damn. How long they lasted?
Maybe a year.
Damn, a year? You really walked the shit out of those Chucks. I had some red Chucks, and they lasted a couple years. Like, the fuck were you doing with them Chucks? This fucking, you were out there running like the Flash and shit. You wore them out of the soles. I had some red Chucks, and I call them the Terry Bogards, because I based them off of the character from King of Fighters. That's what he wore, red Chucks. Yeah. So, yeah, Chucks, it's true that the more worn out they look, the cooler they look.
It's right?
Something special about the Chucks. Mines were really cool until they had like a hole in there. So, you know, I had fun. I had to get rid of it. And I've been meaning to get more, and I still haven't got some Chucks. Every year I say I'm going to get some Chucks, and I still haven't.
I do too. I actually have some saved that I want, and then I never buy them.
See? Me too. I got a whole bunch of Vans I don't wear.
Dude, Vans were my shit for, like, a long time because they had that, like, puffy version, like, mm-hmm. for skateboarders. And then they went to, like, slip-ons with no padding. And I was like, I don't like this. And started buying different ones, like Tony Hawk's and stuff like that.
I started wearing, like I said, after Adidas, I was wearing comfortable shoes that had cushion on
padding.
Them. Yeah, like Brolyfist says, I bet y'all didn't wear K-Swiss. I was fucking sporting them K-Swisses, motherfucker. Don't even start me. I was sporting K-Swisses, Sacconis. I think Sacconis were the most comfortable fucking shoes I ever wore. I don't even know if they still make them. K-Swisses, Sacconis, Skechers. I still got some Skechers.
Skechers. I had some Skechers boots.
Yeah, they make those. Yeah, they do make those.
Yeah, they were still towering. You could kick the shit out of anybody.
Oh, shit. I need some of those. N1s? I didn't wear N1s. I wore... My favorite Nikes were the Nikes SBs. I love those. They were like the skateboarding Nike shoes. They were really dope.
I had these Nikes that look like Chucks.
The Nike Chucks.
And they didn't last long. They were uncomfortable to tell, too.
What was another shoe? I was going to mention, there was some kind of shoe. I forgot. FUBU?
FUBU.
FUBU shoes?
You know I have FUBU everything. Everything.
Now I mostly got a whole bunch of Reeboks because they're the ones that did those Power Ranger shoes.
That's right.
And some I got a whole bunch of different shoes. My shoes are everywhere. But the ones I wanted, okay, I almost got there. I mentioned, that I always wanted some British Nikes.
Oh, wow, yeah.
That's what I always wanted, and they still have them, and I was meaning to get some. I wanted to bring back the British Nikes.
So you can be like, what's his name? The funny guy. The fro and the hot tub movie, Hot Tub Time Machine.
What's
his name, like Chris Robertson or something?
Yeah, yeah, I know who you're talking about. He does all the commercials for like Pizza Hut now.
Pizza Hut, yeah.
Make that money.
Be like him from Pineapple Express and wear some fucking British Knights.
I'm telling you. Okay, this year, guys, this year, I'm going to do it. I'm going to get me some BKs. I'm going to sport the shit out of them. I'm going to start dressing up like I'm in the fucking 90s, all right? I'm going to dress up like I'm in the fucking tongue out. B-boy style. Fuck that, dog.
I'm going to get some real Chucks, and hopefully they don't break off my foot. And then I'm going to start wearing flannels again and ripped up jeans.
We're gonna dress up like Raven from WCW, dog.
What about me?
That's how we're gonna dress up. This year's gonna be crazy. All right, that's our goal. Get some BKs, some Chucks, and dress like we're part of the fucking Raven. What was this fucking group called? Fuck, man. Raven Flock or some shit like that? The New Flock. There you go, Scooby. The New Flock. We're gonna create the New Flock. 2024, the year of the New Flock. We're gonna be
lookout, bitch.
We're gonna be sitting like him in the turnbuckle all the time, just chilling. There was a picture I saw of him chilling on the turnbuckle, fine ass bitch in the middle. And I'm like, damn, Raven. I don't remember that. That was goals right there. Check it out. Hold on. I'm gonna show it right here. Look. Look at Raven. Come on.
It's blurry as shit.
I know. I'm trying to. Come on, Raven. Ah, it's blurry. Anyways, that's Raven and some hot ass chick. And he's just.
Wow.
That's goals right there. I got to recreate that picture with my wife. She's going to be like, hell no.
You have to have a gimlet like fucking Little John.
What?
The current cup.
The what?
His cup.
Oh, the crunk cup. Yeah. I'll do that. Hell yeah. And it's flannel. It has flannel around it. Crunk cup with flannel around it. That's what we're going to do.
There you go.
That's how we're going to do. Phantom, I said that's kimono wanalaya.
Wanalaya.
Wanalaya. Well, I hope he was.
Is that?
I hope he was giving
like
it to
a, a James Bond girlfriend. Wanna Leia.
Raven was the James Bond of wrestling.
He had little tricks and gadgets and shit.
Oh, shit. Well, with all that, you know what time it is. Let's screenshot the motherfucking news.
Screenshot the news.
And our first fucking news here. Some reason after that video popped up where the car got on fire and the fucking Stanley Cup. Still, every time they say Stanley Cup, though, I'm thinking NHL.
Me too.
Right? I'm not the only one.
I'm like, your team is going to win the cup? I don't think so. The Penguins are doing pretty good this year.
I'm not the only fucking one. Here, I'm going to screen so you're with me. You know?
Cool.
Yeah, because I know you'd be waiting. But yeah, so ever since that video came out and that Stanley Cup, this thermal cup, right? That's what you call them? Thermal cup or whatever?
Yeah.
They just been blowing up and they've been making special editions and people are flocking and lining up for this. And I'm like, calm down. It's not that serious, dude.
Chill out.
Chill the fuck out. I'm glad my wife is not crazy about them. Like, she loves stuff like that, but she got some other type that she's like, oh, this is dope. Look, you could drink it and, or you could use it as a straw. She just loves that shit. She's not going crazy for this pink Galentine's Day Starbucks Stanley Cup.
And Jesus wept.
Also, is a Starbucks supporting Israel right now? You motherfuckers fucking up.
Anytime people start talking about like Israel and Palestine and all that, I just think of that Homer the Simpson gif where he's like, going backwards into the bushes, like
yeah, pretty much. I'm more on the field of Dave Chappelle when he's like, oil, what oil, what, and then knocks over the water and runs off. That I'm more on that fence. It's like Israel, Gaza, what, knock over the water, run away. Oh, confirm Marvel's Daredevil is MCU canon. Okay, first of all, when was it not? I understand they were like, no, it's not. Look, I never believed them when they said, no, it's not. Like, motherfucker, it happened. It is canon. I don't know why this.
And then, especially in the beginning when Marvel was, like, really popular and doing really well, and they came out with this, and they said it was canon back then. Mm-hmm. And then later, when they started doing, like, more the Avengers and stuff like that, they're like, oh, that's not really canon. Then why did you say it was in the beginning? His fucking character is in Spider-Man.
Like, that's like official. Like, when he showed up in Spider-Man, I was like, all right, you're canon as fuck. You know, like, you can't really get out of there. It's one show that ended up not being canon was Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Like, it was alongside it, and then it just went off its own fucking trail. It went somewhere else. It was hard to try to make a canon.
Homeboy, like, died and came back as an alien, and it was crazy.
There were one season, they were in the future fighting the Kree. Earth was already destroyed. I'm like, what's going on here? And then the season after that, I think they tackled the multiverse first, because then they were like facing a multiverse version, evil version of Coulson. And then at the end of the series, I think it ended up just being another multiverse. Like, there was just another universe where they were still there. So I don't know, man. It was fun. It was fun as fuck. The Ghost Rider season was like the best, but other than that, I don't know. But yeah, everybody's saying this is canon officially because on Disney Plus, they put it on the timeline of their, MCU.
Nice.
Fucking thing.
I just want to go back and rewatch that first season for the fight scenes.
I am rewatching Daredevil when they're close to releasing the new Daredevil. I am gonna do that. I'm gonna watch every season of Daredevil with the Defenders. I'm not gonna watch the other seasons. I'm not giving that much time. I'm not giving that much dedication to Jessica Jones and Luke Cage and Iron Fist. Not that I didn't like them, but it's like Daredevil's main goal. And if you haven't watched Echo, watch that shit. It's really good. The first episode is my favorite, though, because of my boy here showed up. But the whole...
Thanks for spoiling
it. Everybody knew he was there. Don't worry about it. He's there. I didn't spoil anything else. But Echo is the shit. It's only 5 episodes. I finished it in one night. It was, like, real quick. It's good. It's good. They went a direction with her, though. Like, look, I haven't read a lot of comics, but I do have the comic where she was, you know, introduced. So I...
Introduced,
yeah. Yeah, I know Echo and Daredevil. I know their story. So what they did was they made their own kind of, like, thing with Echo. So I'm like, but I'm also not hating it. I'm like, all right, you know, this is the MCU. You got to understand that the MCU is its own thing, its own universe. So things are going to be kind of different. But overall, it's really, really good. And I think Echo is a prime example, like Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage. You know, I would say Iron Fist, but not a lot of people like Iron Fist. It's an example of people like that kind of version of Marvel superheroes, where it's more realistic with some sense of supernatural or powers and shit like that, you know? Where it's more on the ground than being, like, crazy out there. Because what we're talking about, what are some of the best MCU movies?
Screenshot the news.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry, guys. I screenshot the news twice. Scooby's going to say something. I know it. I'm waiting for Scooby to say something in the chat, Scooby. I know it. You're going to talk some shit. Morbius? And now I forgot where I was going.
I hate Morbius. Yeah.
Nah, Morbius, I didn't hate it. Oh, we starting over again? No, Scooby. You see? I knew
we never started over. What are you talking about, man?
Civil War. Like... You know, like Civil War, more on the ground, not too crazy, espionage, and people really loved it, being one of the big
Are you talking Marvel about the movies. Comics or the movie?
No, the movie. Oh. I'm talking about, like, when it comes to more on the ground, realistic, and not too far off, people love it. When it gets too crazy, which is funny because Ragnarok, crazy as shit, people loved it. Love and Thunder, crazy as shit, people hated it. It's what you want, you know?
I think The Winter Soldier is one of my favorites to watch because...
That one, that's what I meant. That's what I meant, not Civil War.
All in all, like, it's like a huge, crazy-ass James Bond movie.
Yeah.
And once you think of it like that, it follows, like, that James Bond movie formula, and I love it.
That was the theme back then because each movie was its own specific genre. Ant-Man was a heist movie. Captain America was espionage. Thor was sci-fi, of course. And Iron Man was Iron Man. I mean, what genre is Iron Man other than Iron Man? Iron Man was Robert Downey Jr.
My mom hates, like, everything that I do, and, like, not everything. We watched Wonder Woman 2, but she went to the theater with me and watched Iron Man 2 and liked it.
Iron Man's the shit, man. Robert Downey killed that. Killed it.
I want my bread.
That's what I still say. That's the one line for that movie. I want my boy.
My bread.
My boy. That guy didn't give a shit. He just wanted his bird. He just wanted to kill Tony Stark and have his bird.
That's it. It's all about the simple thing, the little things in life.
Yeah, you don't ask for much. Kill you, keep my bird. That's it.
That's it.
God damn it.
I ain't mad at him.
I ain't mad at him at all. I am mad at Warner Brothers because they won't let David Ayer just fucking put out the director's cut, man. This guy.
It exists. It exists. He said it exists. And they won't let him put it out.
They won't. But then I think WB is going to be under new management or owned by someone pretty soon. So hopefully those motherfuckers. Oh, no. That, I don't know if this was screenshotted in your stuff, but apparently, like, Tom Cruise is going to have a lot of power in WB right now.
It's in there.
Yeah, it's in there. Okay, we're going to get to it. So David Ayer wants his fucking director's cut out there. I'm going to hope that the fans still make it happen. He's giving up. So I hope in the end we win and we get to see his freaking cut. It's not going to matter in the theme, but it doesn't matter. We just want to see the version that he was talking about. On the good news, though, David Ayer got a banger out starting right now, actually, in theaters.
The Beekeeper.
Boy, I've been hearing Jason Statham got down in this movie, and David Ayer directed a banger.
I see it so bad.
I do, too. I do, too. So that means I'm going to have to wait for it to be at home. It's not that I don't like to go to the movie theaters. I do. I love it. It's just I don't get the luxury of being able to have time to go to it. And then I do have the luxury of having an at-home movie theater. So once it hits Vudu, baby, it's like, all right, I'm either renting or buying this motherfucker and I'm watching it. You see, that's me supporting. I still support. I just support at home.
I think movie theaters as a whole is the most passive-aggressive way of robbing you blind.
Robbing you blind? Is it the snack bar?
It's good God. Can I get some Reese's Pieces and a large Cherry Coke? Yes, that'll be $9,000.
No, you know what they're charging a lot for? Now they're selling like special novelty freaking popcorn bins and whatnot.
Really?
Yeah, I got one. I got the Ninja Turtle one when I went to go see TMNT.
Yeah.
There was a Optimus Prime one. Like the whole fucking semi and the semi part or the cargo part was where you put the popcorn in.
Yeah.
Brother-in-law has one for when he went to go see Dungeons and Dragons. It's a big 20 dice. 20, nice. That's what you call it, right?
Die.
Yeah, it's a big 21. That's a fucking popcorn thing. It's that's how they get you. Every time I go there, there's something new. There was one for Barbie. There's one for Blue Beetle. The Blue Beetle one was the Blue Beetle. And you opened it and you could put popcorn in it.
Oh, my God.
That's how they get you. They're expensive as fuck, though.
I bet.
They're either 30 and up.
Spin Dog says, that's why you bring snacks from home. Let me tell you, I know exactly how many bean and cheese burritos from Taco Bell I can fit into my purse.
I know this.
I can fit a whole Chipotle burrito in there. I can get snacks on the side. Like, I'm good. I never pay for shit unless I'm like, oh, fuck. I came here on a whim and I didn't bring anything. Oh, they're going to take my whole rent money.
back when... In high school, the movie theater that I went to was across the street from a Burger King. So I just got a fucking, like, you know, chicken sandwich from Burger King. Wow. Go and fucking brought that bitch inside the movie theater and started eating that motherfucker. Take that.
Take that, like an Arby's bitches. Night.
Take that, you bitch asses, motherfuckers. So we go from David Ayer not getting his director's cut out there and being seen to another low point, which I really believe this is, you know, I think this movie is getting bad credit and is actually pretty good, but apparently The Marvels is officially Disney's lowest grossing MCU movie of all time. Bet you when I watch it is, because from what I've seen, people who've seen it, they had a blast watching it. Is it the best? No. But is it the worst? No. It was a very, very enjoyable fucking movie. Sadly, I didn't go see it. But that motherfucker should be at home by now. Like, where is it? You know?
Yeah. I don't understand what's happening with that.
You could have gained your losses by having it available at home. Put it on Vudu. I'll actually fucking rent it or buy it. Like, let me watch this fucking movie. So it's sad. I mean, on Brie Larson's part, I don't know. There's a Brie Larson, I love you for Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Your interpretation of Captain Marvel, though, so far hasn't been to my liking. Yeah, and apparently in real life you're cunty, and I don't like it. So I'm really banking on the Marvels that you did it right. But Miss Marvel over there and the other one, I forgot what her name is. They're the shit, and I got a little crush on Miss Marvel right now. I'm telling you, this girl's she's cute as fuck. She's cute as fuck. So
I just think it's the look that they went with that fucked them over. It just does. It looks cheesy. It looks like it'd be on Nickelodeon or Disney Channel. See, it doesn't look like, oh, this is gonna be like Superman but with women. Like, no, it just. Maybe that's just me.
I think that's just you. I think people just didn't give it because they didn't care. They probably saw that like, oh, this, whatever, you know, it's the fatigue. And it was like, oh, no, the fucking superhero shit and blah, blah, blah. But then there's also the fact, like, when Aquaman came out, it didn't do so well either. But people weren't bashing it like crazy. And people are like, why aren't you bashing this like crazy? It's because it's not female-led movie. You know what I'm saying?
Like, oh, Aquaman for like a week or two was at the top. Like, people are saying it's badass.
It was cool. We went to go see it. It was cool. It wasn't like, you know, bad, but it was cool. I don't hate it because the thing with Aquaman 2 is it was the last one, and you can tell Jason Momoa just like had fun. He went full on Momoa, and it was fun. And it was a fun movie. It didn't suck. They even made fun of how, like, in the first Aquaman movie, you know, when they just get interrupted by explosions. Do you remember that? Did you see the first movie? Did you fucking see Aquaman? Okay, so remember how there was always an explosion, always an explosion? Yeah. Did I lose you? You're frozen. You're frozen. You're good? You're good now? You're moving.
I think I'm good.
Yeah, you're moving now. You hear me?
I'm trying to. I hear you.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Can you fucking hear me? I remember that was from something. I don't know what. I don't know what that was from, but that was from something. Scooby says Marvel was good. You see, I just got to wait for the Marvels to show up on Disney Plus or Vudu or something. Let me fucking watch it. I got to buy it because, look, I'm invested in physical media when I already started a collection. So everything DC and everything Marvel, I got to keep them going. Everything Fast and Furious, keep it going. Everything Star Wars, keep it going because I have them all. You know what I'm saying? Just keep it going.
I did that with The Matrix and look what happened.
You got four movies, right?
Well, it's five because Animatrix, but.
Yeah, that's Animatrix. You're right. You're right.
It wasn't that good.
You're right. The Marvel's officially Disney's. Well, you know, we'll see, man. I bet you when I watch the movie, it'll be good. So, whatever. It sucks. I think they had it against them the whole time. It could be because it was all women. Could be because of, like you said, people just looked at it and are like, eh. Go ahead.
I think people thought it was going to be too woke.
That could be it, too.
Fuck that shit.
That could be it. No, that first Captain Marvel was woke as hell, and my wife pointed that shit out, and she really, really doesn't like it. And we even tried it again, and then I was like, yeah, you're kind of right. It is a little bit too fucking woke. And it sucks, man. It sucks because, you know, I like Captain Marvel, but it did too much. But Captain Woke. I'm really interested in it because I found out while the movie was out and they were doing all their press and everything like that, that the director, she was inspired by anime and video games.
For what?
The Marvels. So when she So when she did action scenes and shot stuff, she was inspired by anime and video games. So I was like, okay, well, now I really want to see this because that's just one of us making a big ass movie, and then no one gave it love. Kind of like Blue Beetle. That was that shit was dope. That should have got a lot of hits, motherfuckers.
All she had to say was the word anime, and people watch it.
I would have been it, like. I don't care about the Creed movies, but in the third movie, I heard he based his whole fight on an anime, and it was all anime shots. And I'm like, well, now I gotta fucking watch Creed 3. And I don't give a shit about Creed.
Watching all these fucking movies.
I know, right? Yeah. It's like, I can't just go to Creed 3. I gotta watch the first one, the second one. I even asked, like, do I gotta watch all the Rockies? How far deep do I gotta go in this shit?
Speaking of anime, I don't wanna spoil anything, but the skateboard scene in Scott Pilgrim Fucked Off or whatever it's called.
That's the next one. Season 2, Scott Pilgrim Fucks Off.
What is it called?
No, it's Scott Pilgrim Fucks Off now. Okay. It's not takes off. It's Scott Pilgrim Fucks Off.
So a homeboy skateboarding to that song from Stefon Ali.
Oh my God. I was cracking up.
The whole song.
He took on all the fact that the paparazzi were ninjas was cracking me up.
Yes. And they just killed the fuck out of him. Okay, they're ninjas. Don't worry about it.
Paparazzi ninjas, man. That fucking show is brilliant. That fucking show is brilliant. All right, here we go. Dwayne The Rock Johnson has expressed the desire to take on more dramatic acting roles because he wants to try to be compared to Dave Bautista. Let's face it.
You can't. Dave Bautista was in Blade Runner. You can't top that.
You can't. Look, I've seen The Rock take on very, very dramatic acting roles. It's called Snitch. I was bored. I didn't finish the movie. I don't know how to see him.
In the car. Is that Drive?
Oh, no, Faster? Drive. That was dramatic.
Faster. That movie's dope.
That was dramatic. That was good. You know what? That was good. Yeah.
Opening scene, man. That movie's awesome.
You're right. That was good. But you see, he played his part, though. He was a guy who was in jail. He came out and he was like, fuck this. I'm going to fuck everybody up. And Snitch, he was like some father who owned a trucking company. And he's like, I got to help my son. And then he got beat up by a bunch of guys. I'm like, you're the fucking Rock. You're fucking six something, swollen shit. You telling me you couldn't take on at least three of them? He's like, scared? Like, get out of my face, man. I want to see The Rock do what The Rock was supposed to do. He's supposed to go in there, kick ass. Boots two asses, you know, and fucking be a badass. I don't want to see him getting beat up and whining and shit.
Bro lost all his cred in one movie. Kind of like when Keanu Reeves was a fucking angry, bitter, redneck piece of shit.
You don't want to see that. You also want to see, look right here, Broly Fist, it's going to be the same like when Tyler Perry tried Alex Wright. You know, according to Cat Williams, Tyler Perry could only play a woman. So that's why that didn't work. It's true.
The only thing that I liked Tyler Perry is when he was in Star Trek.
Yeah. He had like that's 2 minutes and that's it. It was gone.
All right. I'm good.
But okay, being serious on Dwayne The Rock Johnson, I want him to succeed and stuff. I want to see him do something serious, and I want it to be dope, and I hope it's something action movie, because I don't want him to just be like some serious role or whatever. Or if you want to go the Dave Bautista route, then just pick your roles right, dude. Pick your fucking roles right. Please. Same.
What was the CIA movie with Kevin Hart?
Oh, Central Intelligence or something like that?
Yeah, that's fucking awesome.
That was a funny ass fucking movie.
Cause he's like silly and, you know, he has that like, yeah, I was a nerd in high school and I peaked, and like, he doesn't understand like
how big and like good looking he is, and he's just still like that little kid from high school.
Fat Dwayne the Rock Johnson was hilarious.
When he's singing in the shower. That was the best shit ever. He went all at it.
And he's great in comedy. Like, he's great in comedy. Him, John Cena, even Dave Bautista's great in comedy. They're great in comedy. But it was
fucking, what's those movies that John Cena did where it's like something about friends or I don't know, where he meets, like, he's dating the girl and they meet the people on the beach and then they, like, keep doing stuff together. Anyway, those movies are really funny.
I don't know. There's some I haven't watched yet with John Cena. I need to step up my John Cena game.
He can be really funny.
Okay, what's going on in this one? Florida woman files lawsuit over Reese's peanut butter pumpkin packaging?
She thought it had the face on it.
Is that why it says, be honest, did you think the Reese's pumpkin would have little faces on it?
She got mad that it doesn't look like that on the inside. It doesn't have the face.
Only in Florida, ladies and gentlemen. Only in Florida. You know, I'm glad my family over there are not dumbs like everybody I hear from Florida. What are we doing? What's in the water in Florida?
Meth.
Maybe if you're born there. Maybe that's what it is. If you're born there, then you just like...
fucking nuts.
Yeah. If you move over there, you're still good. But if you're born there, you're just fucking nuts. Sorry to any Florida listeners in the machine room, but if you are a Florida listener, please answer our question. What is going on over there? And did you also expect a fucking face in the pumpkin Reese's? Scooby said, I thought we had the face on it too.
Low key, the first time I had those, I totally thought it was gonna have the face. Then I opened it, I was like, "Oh,
right." But you didn't go like, "I'm a fucking sue."
Calling my fucking lawyer right now.
We're not gonna. This is a false advertisement.
There was that lawsuit against Red Bull because it didn't give you wings.
You know what? This year, let's just sue for no reason. Let's do it. Let's see how far we can go. Let's see how far we can fucking go.
Let's sue Butterfingers because it doesn't really make that sound.
But they were so good, though. They were good. It's Reese's. They're fucking good. Oh, this is funny. And I've seen the video of this. Fucking Christopher Nolan got called out by his Peloton instructor for Tenet. Let me find that video. You gotta listen to this chick go off. Hold
that
on.
That was cold-blooded.
I hope right when I put Peloton, it better show up. Peloton. Tenet. Damn it. I can't see what the fuck I'm typing. Hold on. No. It's cool. I got it. Where is it? You gonna show it? I wanted to just show it, not fucking...
Wasn't it up at the top?
No, because that looked like it was... No. This looked like they're about to... Yeah, there's some guy talking about it.
Yeah, gross.
I don't wanna... Okay, this one right here. It's gotta be it, right here.
This song is from the soundtrack of a movie called Tenet. Anybody see this shit? Did anybody see this besides me? Because I need a manual. Someone's gotta explain this. Yeah, I'm not kidding. What the fuck was going on in that movie? Do you understand? Seriously, you need to be a neuroscientist to understand. And that's 2.5 hours of my life that I want back. I want it back. This song is...
She was really mad.
No.
She was really fucking mad. She couldn't follow Tenet.
Wow.
Bruh.
Exactly.
I'm sure a lot of people were like that. My wife and I, we watched Tenet and we were like, yo, what the fuck? We gotta watch that again. That's how we were. We were like, what the fuck? Did we just, the hell? That shit made no sense.
Exactly what it's like trying to watch Mulholland Drive by David Lynch. You're like, I need to watch this like 10 times and I'm still not gonna get it.
That's what I'm saying. And movies like, at least movies like that, you're like, oh shit, I gotta watch it. There are movies where I'm like, what the fuck did we just watch, man? The last movie that had me like that was, it's not Arrival, the other one. But I think Sandra Bullock was in it. Was it Sandra Bullock?
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
No, that wasn't Sandra Bullock. It was Scarlett Johansson. No, who the fuck was it?
Google it.
Okay, it's not Sandra Bullock. I don't think it's Sandra Bullock. I'm gonna look up Sandra Bullock and see if movies. It's not her. It was someone else. Because she did Bird Box. The movie? I don't remember the movie. I just remember it coincided with The Arrival. It was another movie.
Natalie Portman?
Natalie Portman. There it is. Natalie fucking Portman. What movie was it?
That's my boo.
Come on, show me this fucking movie. What fucking movie was it? Annihilation. People praising the shit out of this movie, Annihilation. This movie left me like, what the fuck did I just watch? I wasted my fucking time with this fucking movie. What does it all mean? That's how that movie left me.
The first time I watched Vanilla Sky, I was like that. But then I was like, I'm going to watch it again.
Oh, yeah.
It was really cool.
Vanilla Sky left me like, damn, that was a crazy-ass twist. And then I always go back to, I let you come inside me.
Crazy. We need that as a sound bite.
I'm being honest, guys. I still debate that I had the Vanilla Sky treatment when I got in an accident. Who's to know? I don't remember that day, but maybe someone fucking just try to kill us both.
You never met me ever.
Maybe this is all a simulation. Maybe this is all a simulation. And this is a perfect segue because we could all be in a simulation if we're ready to be in a Ready Player One kind of world.
Let's do it.
Guys, they're actually working on this. I mean, we already got some of this. You know, if you see Fortnite is Ready Player One already. But imagine it if it's like VR and we're in there and we finally get to be anybody, anything, and do everything. I'm waiting for that world.
I'm going to be that this something like this, like on a serious note, for people that are disabled, could play this and, you know, wouldn't be impaired anymore and they could do things and, you know, it would help.
It'll be the best, man. It'll be living the dream, dude. I want to drive the DeLorean.
I want to hang out with Duke Nukem.
Dude, you could be Duke Nukem. Matter of fact, I want you to be Duke Nukem and just go after all the feminist people in that world and piss them the fuck off. Piss them the fuck off. I'm Duke Nukem,
and you can suck my balls.
Exactly. Scooby knows this one person I'm talking about. Scooby, you remember? I'm going to call her out. I don't give a fuck, man. I'm like Donald Trump right now, you know? No, fuck that. I'm not like Donald Trump. I'm like Hunter Biden right now. Fuck it. I'm going to call her out. Her name was Janaida. Scooby remembers. She turned into some crazy-ass feminist. And there was, I think I told you this, there was this big freaking display of Duke Nukem. And she was, like, all against it because, like, oh, how dare they freaking endorse this and it's showing men dehumanizing women and blah, blah, all this shit. And I swear to God, it was I immediately unfollowed, blocked. I'm like, I ain't dealing with this shit. That's fucking, that's stupid. Like, It's fucking a video game, girl. Like, how's your fucking... This is the person who was, like, praising the shit out of America Chavez's first comic book that was written by a lesbian, and it was the worst fucking comic ever. The worst.
That's hilarious.
But anyways, who's ready for Ready Player One?
I saw something recently. I don't know if it was a movie or if I made it up. But it was like, there was like a bad guy, and then there was a girl, this lady and a guy. And the girl was like, you can't shoot me, I'm a woman. And then the other guy in the room's like, yo, what about equal rights? And then the bad guy just shoots her.
That's what's
he's
up.
Like, he goes, I like this feminist thing.
Dude, I watched, we're watching Jackie Chan, and I swear the first two police stories, Jackie was just giving it to women. Slapping the shit out of them, tossing them, treating their ass. I was like, damn, equal rights with Jackie over here in the 80s. He didn't give a fuck.
What was Bill Burr was talking about when women got all mad after Sean Connery died? Like, how can you celebrate a man that said it was okay to hit women? And Bill Burr's like, he didn't say it was okay to hit women. He said, just give him a little slap.
A little slap in their butt. A little slap in the butt. A little pep. Anyway, who is that? Who you want to be? Like Duke Nukem in Ready Player One? Who would you want to be?
Who do I want to be? A xenomorph from Alien.
Ooh, that's dope. That's dope. I didn't see that coming.
All wet and shit.
I didn't see that coming. That's nice. I have no idea what I would want. You know what? No, I do know what I'll be. I'll be Vash. I'll be Vash from Trigun. Fuck it. I'll go that route first. Why not? I'll get that skin.
Yes.
VR is like just stepping up its game, and it's gonna get to that level, and I can't wait. It's fun. There's a lot of VR games right now that's really fun. Scooby's gonna be Kenshin. You see, me and Scooby, we're gonna be Vash and Kenshin. We're gonna be anime characters just out there fucking shit up. I'll be Vash in a DeLorean. I'm getting a DeLorean. I don't give a shit. Spendog will be Cat Williams. Matter of fact, Cat Williams made the fucking Oasis.
He invented virtual reality.
He invented the metaverse.
When he was 4 years old by himself.
Because he read nothing but 3,000 books. 13,000. Right?
Jesus Christ. 3,000.
Something wrong.
He used to read 3,000 books a year. That's impossible. Impossible.
But, you know, someone did mention, doesn't mean he finished them. You know, he could read like a chapter or two. That's okay.
That's how I get through books. You're like, oh, you got a cute little library. I'm like, I've read the first or two chapters of all those books.
It's just an insert. You had like a Reader's Digest. Remember, they used to have just inserts of books. That's what you had, Reader's Digest. Go through that shit. That's all you need.
Pokemon. From the first chapter, if I don't get the whole book, I'm not going to finish.
Fuck it. I don't give a shit. I'm not going to look for this book. The Pokemon TV app featuring classic anime episodes has been removed from digital storefronts and will be discontinued completely in March. Didn't even know.
Something for our anime fans, but yeah, you got to watch Pokemon somewhere else.
There's a lot of places to watch Pokemon. Look. I gave up on Pokemon when he lost the first fucking tournament to Gary, and then he didn't win a tournament until what, last year or some shit like that?
After 25 years.
Yeah, I'm pretty good where I left off. It's okay. I'm not gonna dedicate my life to all that. You saw that? I got scared of fuck. What are you guys doing? Fucking cats. Scared the shit out of me.
I used to work with this lady at this warehouse I worked at, and we were working in like doing repackaging videos, and we had like a whole section of Pokemon. And she was like, they're evil. They're from the devil. I'm like, what are you talking about? It's a kid's show. I've watched it. It's so tame, except the rocket guy always has titties.
Look, people will find something. I'm sure you can talk to someone and they'll be like, yeah, Pokemon is evil and it's saying this and that. Look, I had a conversation at work. My boss tried to fucking ruin Disney for me. All right?
With all the sex stuff?
She was, look, she came in and she was like, if you guys need anything, like work related, you know, like fucking hand warmers or coffee, cocoa, whatever. And I'm like, I made a joke. I was like, yeah, can I get an all expensive paid trip to Disneyland? And she's like, you don't want to go there. That's where the pedals are at. I'm like, oh, the fucking shit. And then she's like, yeah, it's all there. Look, Monsters, Inc., Pinocchio, it's all pedophilia and about the pedals and stuff like that. And I'm like, oh, yeah, that's interesting. And I'm like, this fucking woman is... All right, I see where we're at.
Wow! All
right, don't worry, that's the most magical place on Earth for me.
That's nowhere where I thought you were going to go with that.
That's exactly where I went. And I was like, okay, I see what you believe in. I'm pretty sure you're probably a Trump supporter as well.
They used to say, I don't know if they still do, is that Pokemon, what it means is demon in your pocket. And they're like, demon, see, it's the devil. You don't understand their culture. That's just what they call things sometimes. It's not like, whatever.
Motherfucker, fictional characters, fictional stories, you bitches. Swear to God, man.
There's this awesome thing that I like to do when I don't like something. I don't watch it.
Exactly.
That's what we should do. That's who we should sue. Let's sue Hulu for making me stay up all night watching Catfish.
There you go. It's fucking with your sleep. You have insomnia now. Yep. Your whole health is affected. They should have a time limit.
I can't think of anything.
Exactly.
People. I think everybody's a catfish.
they should have a time limit. The app should know when to make you stop watching. Yep. And because of that, you got to sue them because they're affecting your life. Now you don't know how to live without watching Catfish.
And they should have a thing after like 8 hours of, you know, consecutively watching a show. And mm-hmm. It's just Joey Coco Diaz's head. And he's like, yo, cut the shit.
Exactly. And we'll also go the route Brolyfus said, where we should sue Tubi just because there are too many mid-movies and they waste your time.
No, he's thinking of Netflix.
Boom. Damn. Speaking of Netflix, I think the show's on Netflix as well. The Orville. Seth MacFarlane gives encouraging update on The Orville. I've watched this show when it first started. I think I stopped in the second season. It's because of their breaks. You know, they have long-ass breaks, yeah. And then it comes back. It came back, like, on Disney Plus, which is also Hulu because they're the same now. And, yeah, he keeps working on this. It's not a bad show. It's a really good show. It was marketed as a comedy, but it's very dramatic.
Yeah.
It's a good show, and I at this point, I probably have to rewatch it again because I don't remember. I remember stuff, but I don't remember everything. I don't even know where I left off. Like I said, I think I stopped in the second season or some shit. But yeah, I would love for The Orville to keep going because it is a good show. He did a good show.
Never seen one episode.
You should. It's a good show. It's pretty good. It is funny, but it's more dramatic than funny. It, like, the funny is in the dramatic. You know what I'm saying? I guess.
Makes sense?
Yeah. So.
Sometimes a situation is so fucked up, it's funny.
Yeah. It's like his own Star Trek. Like, this guy really said, I'm going to make a Star Trek. Fuck it.
I think he's kind of focused, too, right now, because they're doing the Ted TV series. It's like a
prequel.
What do you call it? Prequel. Thank you. His parents are different actors now.
I have beef with it because the kid doesn't look like no young Mark Wahlberg at all. So, I say bad casting. I also didn't know this guy left. Like, he still does Family Guy and American Dad, but he left the writing process, like, ages ago. Yeah, so, he just does the voices.
He just comes in and does the voices, and he's still an executive producer. So, he can be like, yo, change this or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, yeah, but he doesn't write or do shit with it. And I don't know if it was his fault, the writers or whoever it was, but, and I'm not trying to be all woke and stuff, but Family Guy and like American Dad, like all of his shows got really homophobic and transphobic,
And so I've kind of distanced myself from Seth MacFarlane stuff. He even did it in like TED 2 and stuff. And it wasn't like funny. It was like aggressive and mean sounding. And I don't know. Some of the jokes were funny, but I just didn't like the direction that like Family Guy was going into. And but from what I heard, he somehow apologized for it, and like everything's been better since then.
Okay, but we have to come to a place where, you know, there should be no. I get it, because there's some trans jokes I heard. I was like, all right, come on, man, like, you know. Yeah. But we also should go in a place where it's like, yeah, don't get so butthurt. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah,
there's gotta be like a middle ground to this shit.
But like, even that, like, I had a beef with, I don't know if it was him or the show or the writers or whatever. I just stopped watching. I didn't fucking go picket in the streets and try to get it taken off the air and sue the, you know, the production company and all this. If you don't like something, just turn it off, dude. There's go find shit you do like.
Like nobody. Which is gonna get a sequel.
I'm so fucking happy.
How fucking, like, come on, man. Christopher Lloyd isn't getting any younger. We gotta get on these movies quickly.
Isn't he like 80?
I'm saying, like, let's make this movie while he's still around, man. Also, Odenkirk is not getting any younger either. Like, come on.
He's old, dude.
Yeah. This motherfucker should be free. There's no more. Damn, why did you just get smaller? There's no more, Saul, you know, he's free as shit. Let's make Nobody 2, 3. Let's do them back to back. Let's do them back to back and release them 5 months apart. Let's go.
Yeah, at least then, you know, if something happens, if he has another heart attack or something, like, at least give us a good trilogy.
Yeah. And then cross over with John Wick. Don't fuck with me. For real. Let's go. Fucking go,
they do like that handshake from Predator. They're just like, I can't do it to myself. But.
John Wick, you son of a, you know, that's how the movie ends.
Exactly.
Straight up, just like that. Hey yo, you gotta tell your cam to fucking calm down, man. I'm getting tired of fixing this motherfucker all the time. God damn. Oh, here we go.
I don't know what's going on.
I don't know
what's going on with my internet right now.
I don't know. Who cares? But I care. I mean, I'll just keep fixing it. It's all good. But, you know, big news, like we mentioned earlier, Tom Cruise is going to have big fucking pull in Warner Brothers. And the first thing I'm hearing is that they really hope he does Edge of Tomorrow too.
Please.
And I'm all for it.
Please do that. And I tell him to bring back, tell him to quit rebooting everything.
Right?
We're getting another Batman and another origin story, and like, chill out, dude. Like,
yeah, I don't know about that. The only Batman, like, for real, now that the Snyderverse is gone, just keep giving me the Batman. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, keep giving me that. That's cool. Like,
I like that universe, the way it's stylized and everything.
Yeah.
The Joker is like phenomenal looking.
Yeah, like you guys tried this universe thing, it didn't work out. Okay, give me a single universe. I'm fine with that. I'm cool with that. You know, just
I'm cool like that. I'm cool like that. Cool like that.
But Scooby, no, I want more Mission Impossible. There's one more. He has to make one more. One more. The story is not finished. You got to finish the story. What did Cody Rose say? You got to finish the story. Mission Impossible needs one more. So does Fast and the Furious. Both these movies need one more. Finish the fucking story.
His first fight, he gets defeated, but he's not really defeated. He just went to another dimension, and then they have to find him.
Yes. Yes. Hell yeah. Get crazy with it. Fuck it. Get crazy with it. Both of these movies... they should die in. Dominic Toretto should die. Ethan Hunt should die. I was going to say Ethan Hunt. Ethan Hawke.
Ethan Hawke, not wrong universe.
Ethan Hawke as Ethan Hunt in Mission Impossible.
No, but Ethan Hawke is coming back to do Black Phone 2.
He is. I haven't seen the first one, so I gotta watch that.
It's pretty good.
I know. There's a whole bunch of fucking.
I thought it was like boring and like a shit at first because it was kind of like generic, and then like it gets amped, and you're like, okay, I'm here for this.
That's what's up. I hope to get to it. It was on my list to watch last year, but you know, I didn't come around it. There's a lot of movies. Like there's a lot of horror movies I need to watch. This one seems great. I remember when this happened. And I remember Nintendo going off on them, but I guess they got a leeway, or maybe they just made it its own. But a game where Pokemon have guns was made while back ago, like maybe a year ago or some shit, and I heard they got a cease and desist, but I guess they just redid it, and it's not Pokemon, and Microsoft grabbed that shit because they know money when they see it, baby.
I'm not gonna lie, as soon as I heard Pokemon with guns, I was like, I'm buying that shit. I don't fucking care how much it costs.
Hell yeah, look at that, Blickymon. Exactly, Blickymon. Is what it should be called. Look at this fucking quote-unquote Pokemon with the Gatling gun.
That's amazing.
You telling me I could have Pikachu with a Uzi?
He's got the devil's breath.
And it's going to be on the Game Pass, so you know we playing it.
Oh, yeah. Like, It's like, what, 4-player? I'm like, dude, fuck yes.
My Pokemon got the Gat on him.
Fucking Gengar with a burner.
And then they're all going to show up on Fortnite and kill it. Straight up. Straight the fuck up. What's this? Twitch has confirmed that just over 500 workers will be laid off, which follows two rounds of layoffs in 2023 that cut around 400 positions. That's fucked up.
It's fucked up, and I'll say this. If something happens to Twitch, we'll be there at kick.com, or we'll follow through, and we'll be on OnlyFans.
Saying, I don't know about Kick, man. I see Kick has people flashing and getting robbed and doing some crazy shit. Kick has a bad reputation already. It's fucked up.
There's that drummer guy that I watch on Twitch, and then he started doing like half his streams on Kick, and he was like, yeah, I really like it here, and I think I'm just going to do Kick by itself because it pays more and this and that. And then like a couple weeks later, he was back to doing just Twitch every day. And I was like, what the fuck happened at Kick? And I've looked, and like other people have left that were on there, and we're guilty of it too. We were on there once.
It's not all that, man. I remember I was streaming my thing, and I streamed it on Kick as well. The only interaction I had there was somebody talking shit to me. That was my Kick interaction. And I'm like, and then when I go back on there, it's still on the fucking chat. Like, I don't know how to take it out of there. So every stream shows that. Are you fat fuck or something like that? And I'm like, what the fuck? That was my Kick experience.
Nice.
And then everything else I hear about Kick is something horrible, like I say. Something fucked up.
We could go to OnlyFans and then really be able to say what we want, and then people gotta pay to see us.
Mm-hmm. Be like, you wanna hear the next fucking podcast? Well, you got a PPV, that's the pay-per-view shit, and get it on the DM and shit like that.
Oh, Danny's here. Oh, hi, Danny.
Oh, hi, Danny. Welcome. All late about it, but Danny came in at the perfect time because one thing that Danny Duadi loves is zombies and zombie movies. And guess what? Something that we mentioned this shit plenty of times. We knew a 28 years later was going to happen. We didn't know it was going to take them 28 years later to do it. But that's right. Oh, shit. We lost. We fucking lost her. Now you guys are hearing the thing. We We lost Hammer Venus right now. I'll try to stall this as much as I can until Hammer Venus comes back. But Danny Boyle and Alex Garland also, I don't know if, no, we're not going to have, did you guys know that his name was Killian Murphy? I thought it was always Cillian Murphy, but it's Killian Murphy this whole fucking time. It was Killian Murphy. But yes, 28 years later with fucking, I don't know who's going to be modem rebooted. Goddamn, her modem rebooted. God damn. Ladies and gentlemen listening and watching right now, Rachel's modem rebooted, so we lost her for a second. So you're going to have to just deal with my soothing voice as I talk about 28 years later. I always knew that the next one would be 28 years later, because how? What else can you do after 20? Well, you could have done, it was 28 weeks, right? You could have done 28 months. But it's been way too long, so you have to go 28 years later. Or, oh shit, I froze. God damn it, I did freeze. Because the shit closed. I'm frozen. It's okay. We'll just, I'll just have this screen on here. I'll close us in the bottom. There you go. Freestradamus. Freeze all. Keep going. I'll pop back in. All right. I got you. So yeah, 28 years later, who's going to be on it? Not sure. I doubt Killian Murphy. Killian Murphy didn't even show up to 28 weeks later. I froze too. The blizzard is here. Damn, we're all scared about this. I ain't going anywhere tomorrow. I never freeze. Who here is excited for 28 years later? And would they still film in that kind of grainy way is my question. And were, did he purposely wait this long to do 28 years later? Did he actually wait 28 years later to do 28 years later? When was 28 days later came out in 2002. It's only 10. No, it is 20. It's about to be 23 years later. So maybe 28 years later won't come out until 28 years later. If that's the case, that's kind of smart and cool. Also, you know, what if you had died before then? But where's the Kill Bill Volume 3? That's my question. I forgot the first one. I forgot the first one too, Scooby Snacks. I got to call you out like that because, you know, we got listeners. So they know that I'm talking to my BFF, Scooby. The beautiful thing is that, okay, Danny said, the beautiful thing is that about it is they know a lot of the fans been waiting. It didn't need to be said. It's true. It's like if they make me wait for the sequel to District 9, I'll go watch it if it's released years from now. But is that the same case with James Cameron's Avatar? Have we been waiting for it? Or we're just like, eh. And then it comes out and we're like, eh, I'll watch it. I'm not saying anything bad about the Avatar movies. They're dope. But the long wait. Look, I haven't met anybody who's like crazy about Avatar. They exist, but I haven't met them. You know, I've been to the Avatar world at Disney World, and I've seen some of these people, but I haven't met them. The sequel is great though. Danny, I suggest this to everybody. The sequel is actually really, really good. The movies are good. Give it a watch. It's not going to kill you. You're at home right now. It's not going to kill you. Give it a watch. It's good. Gets real crazy at the end. You haven't even seen Alita Battle Angel? Danny Do ID, what do you do with your time? Listen, listeners out there in the Machine Room podcast, you have to watch Alita Battle Angel. If there's anything in your life, watch Alita Battle Angel. It's the best freaking anime adapted movie ever. Okay, this is a movie by James Cameron, directed by Robert Rodriguez, that also he's been trying to make since the 90s. And yet, he's so focused on the avatars, I want Alita Battle Angel. Where is the sequel to Alita Battle Angel? And the thing is that they could take their time and make it. Homegirl doesn't have to stay young because it's all computer generated, her body. But still, let's fucking make the sequel to Alita Battle Angel. I think that's more wanted than Avatar is. Not saying stop Avatar. Don't stop it. You're invested. And I want to see where they keep going. Just don't make me wait another fucking 13, 15 years or whatever. Or 28 years later to watch the next fucking Avatar movie, okay? Like, don't leave such a big gap. That's why we stop losing interest. Because the gap is so fucking long. Imagine we watch MCU movies like, hey, that fucking Avengers is coming. And it doesn't come until like 28 years later. You saw the other version of Alita Battle Angel? The OVA? Or you found a porn of it? I don't know what you're talking about, Broly Fizz. Right now, Hammer of Venus taking a long time to get here. And this show is supposed to be ending by now. We already got to the last screenshot. 20 years later is the last conversation on this list. When's she going to show up? Tomorrow? She's going to show up and be like, all right, everybody, good night. You know what I'm saying? Like, right now, this show is just me. I'm just talking with y'all. Please keep talking to me. And people listening right now, I hope you're enjoying just me. There's no interaction. It's just me in the chat room right here. If you're watching the video, you can see the chat room right there. You see Broly Fizz, Danny Do ID, Scooby Snacks. James Cameron is on a ship cruising in the ocean somewhere. He's going to make a movie about the oceanic thing. How you tell me that James Cameron... Look, it's funny how James Cameron was able to go down there. He keeps going to the fucking Titanic. That's why he made the movie, because he's obsessed about the Titanic. He goes down there. He does it. He keeps surviving. These guys try to go do it with a fucking toilet paper roll, and they all died. Nobody finds... Did you guys hear the joke Dave Chappelle said about those people? Oh shit. Oh, that's hilarious. Which that new Netflix special, I'm iffy about it. It was alright. I still feel like, you remember when I said like when you're doing a joke and you're overdoing it and it's like way too much, it's like, okay, motherfucker, move on. That's how I feel Dave Chappelle is right now. It's like, I love you, dude. You're one of the greatest comedians of our time. But you're focusing on one topic of jokes, one group of people that you should just keep moving on, dude. Like, it's like overdone now. I'm over it. Okay, I get it. Move on. Let's go. I want him to talk about so much stuff, and he's still talking about the same shit. It's like, stop it. There's so much shit. Right now, Dave Chappelle should be making jokes about everything that just happened in this fucking month alone since the new year started. The flying felon, the freaking aliens in Miami, the Gypsy Rose. These are things that he should be fucking talking about. But he's talking about... He did do the submarine joke on his new special, and it's like a stupid dad joke, but it is kind of funny because it is so fucking stupid. I'm dying here, Way. This gotta end. Welcome to the Machine Room Podcast, where Hammer Venus gets kicked out of her own podcast, and I'm left here carrying everything. At this point, it turns to Only Naz, which was my podcast, and I stopped that podcast because I was just like, oh! I think we got something. For Christ's sake, are you back? Hello? Are you out there? I cannot see you, but I could hear you. There you are. Oh shit, a new angle too. Damn. Hold on.
I'm on my phone.
Oh shit. Oh, okay, that makes sense. I was gonna say it's more it's like a phone angle.
Yeah, that's the phone angle.
There you go.
And do like this.
There you go. There you go. That's better. Gives me a better ratio here. Damn, motherfucker, you should do it off your phone. That shit is crispy clear.
This is the selfie camera. The cameras in the back are way better.
That's dope. So yeah, I just been here talking. You're killing me, Smalls. I gotta fix all my shit. Well, I was discussing how it took them 28 years later to make 28 days later. Then I just went on a crazy ass rant, and then I was just like, "That's the last screenshot, guys," and she's killing me right now. That's it. So, now that you're here, I mean, your two cents about 28 years later.
I don't think it actually is 28 years, but it's pretty close. So yeah, I'm for it. I also hope that if they do another Jeepers Creepers, that it's like a direct sequel to the second one. What was it supposed to be like 24 years later? 22?
I don't know, because I don't think I've seen any. I don't think I've seen another Jeepers Creeper. I don't know if I saw the second one. All I know is that the guy who created it is controversial, you know?
He's like a bad pedo. Like, he got caught with video footage. Like,
he's bad.
And when you realize that and you know that, it makes Jeepers Creepers a whole different kind of movie.
And you see, and this is where my fucking boss would come up to you and be like, "Did you know Jeepers Creepers is just a metaphor for pedophilia?" Along with Monsters, Inc. I'm like, don't fucking ruin my childhood. Monsters, Inc. is a fucking masterpiece. Stop it.
God, when you said ruin childhood earlier, it reminded me of that my mom had like a little party phase one time. And she would work her ass off. She worked like 4 or 5 days a week, like 16-hour days. So then, like, you know, on one of her nights off, she'd go out and like drink and stuff. And so she had some friends from that, and this guy Jody, the guy I got the combat boots from, they came home one night blasted, just off their ass. And Jody starts putting in all of our Disney movies, like the classic VHS. We had like all of them. And he starts going through them and fast forwarding and rewinding and all this stuff to get to all the scenes that have something to do with sex. And that shit blew my mind.
Was he going to like the Lion King? It's like, look, it says sex.
Yeah. Yeah. And then like the Little Mermaid with the boner and the dick. And there's a lot of them out there.
Yeah, that's true. That's fine. If you came to me, it's like, did you know there's all these little secret symbols and symbolisms and the thing? Yeah, that's fine with me. I'm cool with that because that's animators. Like, I remember one, apparently some animators were so mad at Disney that they put in like people fucking in the Rescuers Down Under or the Rescuers, the first movie or something like that, in the window. Yeah, they're like, that's cool with me. I'd laugh at that. I'll be like, hell yeah, I would have done that too. But if you come at me be like, did you know that Monsters, Inc. is just about pedophilia? And I'm like, come on. Don't fucking do it. You know what Pinocchio's really about? Ah, pedophilia. And I'm like, come on, stop it. Did you know Toy Story 2 is just pedophilia? And I'm like, stop it.
That same guy that did Jeepers Creeper, the pedo guy, he also did another favorite movie of mine called Powder. And Powder is like beautiful, it's amazing. I'm watching it, I'm like, this should be studied in schools, and why doesn't people talk about it? And then I saw who directed and wrote it. I was like, oh,
did you know that Powder is about pedophilia? I'm just gonna say that for everything now. Let's go movies and shit. Hey, like, wait, years from now, when this movie comes out, 28 years later, hey man, 20 years later is great. It's like, yeah, did you know it's about pedophilia? Did you know the zombies are actually pedos and we're all the kids running from them? Powderphilia.
Like, ruin anything. You could be at a restaurant and just say the word pedo, and that restaurant would go under the next day.
I know, and I'm just like, that's my friend, pedo. That's what we call him. Damn, what the fuck?
What did he do to y'all?
Like, yeah, I told you not to call me pedo, man. People just take it wrong. Well, I'm sorry, Pedro. You've always been pedo to us since fifth grade, bruh. Nobody calls you Pedro.
They did that on the IT Crowd, and they had that character name was Peter File.
Yes. Danny is like, you know the movie Sound of Freedom was about human trafficking? Yeah, something like that. Did you know? did you know? And did you know that the Machine Room podcast is one of the greatest podcasts out there, that if your friends are not listening to it, they should be. So tie up your friends and family members, force them to listen to us and force them to watch it to us, because we're having a ball here, and don't lie, so are you. This is what, our third episode of the year? Or second? I think it's the second episode of the year. And we're doing good so far. We're doing great. And we even got a new intro. Once again, shout out to Minda Martinez. Check him out on Twitch, Minda Martinez 2. He usually does morning streams, but he also... Yeah, early as shit. But one great place to follow him is on TikTok. Now, I'm just going to make sure that his name is the same on TikTok. Mind of Martinez. Yes, it is... Mind of Martinez 2 on TikTok. Follow him on TikTok. He puts a lot of great freaking clips from his theme. So yeah, much love to him. Thank you for doing the intro for us. And we got to have him on the show one day. I told him we're going to have him, and we haven't, but we got to have him on the show one day. So let's try to make that happen.
He's officially now and forever part of the Machine Room.
Yes, we officially have him on the show. But let's have him so he could talk with us on the show. There you go.
Absolutely.
Yes, let's do that. Vote Kingpin for president, everybody. Scooby said it. Kingpin 2024.
Now I need to create a shot for three speakers.
Yes. Yes, we need to do that. We need to do that. I know you got it. So everybody, thank you for being with us. I'm Nastrodamus. She's Hammer Venus. Oh, over here. She's Hammer Venus. And this is the Machine Room Podcast. You ain't got to go home, but you got to get the hell out of here. Watch Alita Battle Angel. Watch Echo. The series is really good. And
Watch Scott
Pilgrim Fucks Up. That's Scooby in the chat room. That's my friend Scooby. Hopefully one day we could get him as well. And
Scooby will always be a part of the Machine Room too.
If you could do it off the phone, we could get Scooby to get on here through his phone.
Yeah, and look at this dope-ass camera.
I know. Scooby got a nice phone, but it is better than what you use. I'm being honest. You look great. HD. HD, yeah, everybody. HD Hammer Venus. HD Hammer Venus. If we get Scooby on here, though, you know that his son is going to show up. It's just going to, like, scoot out of the way. It's going to take over. So it's going to be like having two people on the show. That's for sure. I know it. Fucking know it. Anyways, guys.
Like I said before, like, this is like an extension of My Way. And mm-hmm. So we have all the My Way people and the Cyber Goons and everybody that supports us and loves us. And we love you back.
Exactly. Because I hate myself. Good night, everybody. I fucking hate myself.
Bitch ass man.
Bitch ass. This bitch. Nas don't know anything. Dumbass fucking ass. Anyways, never say goodbye, because on a Sunday, we will see each other. We will reach each other. That's what I was going to say. Never say goodbye, because on a Sunday, we will reach each other. That sounded pedophilic. Is that even a word?